Hey, what's up everyone? Muscle here from Koppelsand. Due to high demand, here is another training guide just for you. We got a lot of suggestions and I thought, hey, let's just all combine them into one big video. So that's what I did. One of the suggestions was that I should remove my character cards. No more OP me. One of the suggestions was that I not only should view the place where you need to train, like just in the map, but also the actual map on the world map. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. And I always highly recommend that you do the quest you find on your way. For example, we're here on our way to Golems and Mushmoom, which are perfect training spots from level 15 to 21. And this sign asks us to kill a few haunt mushrooms, so that's what we did. It's only like 20, it's quite fast XP, and you'll get new equipment, because if you don't have any character cards or anything else, you'll take a lot of damage, and every new equipment is welcome. So we're at Mixed Golems now, and a few things have changed. For example, Bruce is here, and Bruce gives you various quests, and I suggest you should complete them. By the way, this is the location of Mushmoom, in case you're wondering. And Bruce is an alright guy, he gives you quite some decent XP from finishing this quest. So really, do them, do the quests. So from level 22 to 30, I trained at Evil Eyes. Now, a lot of you people said, well, hey Koppelsand, I really like your training spots, but all these spots always are so crowded. So if you don't want to train at Evil Eyes, you can always go to Phantion and train there at Kaloon. And Kaloon are quite decent to train at. Also, you can train at the next map when you're around level 36, 37, so you can always come back here if you want to. Another alternative are the Street Lights, Baby Boulder Munches and the Big Boulder Munches from level 20 to 40. And no, you don't train at one spot from level 20 to 40. I recommend you train at Street Lights from 20 to 25. 25 to 30 you go to Baby Boulder Munches, and from 30 to 40 you go to Big Boulder Munches. The Street Lights you can find right here, and the Boulder Munches are right to your left. To your left, of course. Yes, right there, to your left. So those are great training spots and great alternatives. So if you don't want to do that, you can do the Elinia Fairy Academy at level 30 to 35. A great short quest line that you can do, just complete. It's quite fun. And after that, of course, from 35 to 50, you go to Gold Richie Beach. It's hard to recommend any other places because this really is the best place you can train at. So from level 50 to 55, I suggest you should do Arena Quests. And arena quests are also quite nice to do, quick short story quest line, and it's quite fun to do. So after that we go to the excavation site from level 55 to 60. The excavation site is near Perion, and I suggest you train here at Skeledogs and Mummies, and then go to Officer Skeletons, and then go to Wooden Masks. So in that order. So right next up is Sleepy Wood. Yes, of course, the Copper Drakes. I know this map can be quite crowded, so if you don't want to go there, there are perfectly fine maps next to it. I know these aren't the great ideal training spots, but it's the best there is if the Copper Drakes are way too crowded. And in the end, you'll be able to challenge Junior Balrog. How awesome is that, right? I know. So always keep in mind that you can do Zekim, and Zekim is a great source of XP. From level 50, I recommend you do easy Zekim. From level 100 or above, you go with normal Zekim. And from level 140 plus, and when you're a bit funded, you can do Chaos Sekim. So from level 70 to 80 we go to White Fangs, and also again this is a very crowded map, so you can go to Lucidas in Orbis, which actually borders with Elmnuth, so it isn't too far away. So next up is the Nihal Desert. From level 80 to 95 we can train at Sandred, Scorpios, Royd, and of course to the Romeo and Juliet PQ. Now the Romeo and Juliet PQ is a great source of XP. Actually, it's the best source of XP there is, but since it can be quite hard to find a party, I suggest you just train here at the Nihal Desert. At this map right here, the Sand Rats at the right, you can train at the lower part of it, but that's, yeah, that isn't just quite as good. The laboratories, however, are great. If you go to the Royds there, oh, godly XP. So from level 95 to 100-ish, you can go to Rash or Red Harps. You can find those monsters in Livre. And Livre is a great training spot, but just don't head too far, because the monsters will get strong pretty fast, and I'm quite sure you're gonna die there if you're not heavily funded or something. So don't go too far, just stay on the right path, and that'll be a great training spot. So next up is from level 100 to 120, we're gonna make our way to the Toy Factory. The Toy Factory is located in Ludus Lake. And I recommend you train at Toy Trojans. The teddies are quite alright. And if you're feeling quite alright, you can train at the Robos. And of course, I'll always recommend this map right here. This one. This one is the best map you can train at. But again, it can be very crowded. So one map to your right or one map to your left won't make any difference. They're still great XP. And after you've completed Ludus Lake, you can go right here to the Fantastic Theme Park. The training isn't quite as fast, but it's actually quite fun to do. So from level 105 and 160, I always recommend you go a few times a day into the evolving world. In this world, no, this isn't the VAC hack, this is actually MapleStory. You can summon monsters and destroy them for great XP. And also another great party quest from level 140 to 180 is the Dimensional Invasion. You can do this party quest a few times a day, but damn the XP, hallelujah. So if you don't want to do this or you can't do it anymore, Elnaut might be the place for you. Dark Yeti and Peppy are great to train at. I recommend you go to Elnaut and fight your way through the deep mine and challenge Shakem all by yourself. It feels like a huge accomplishment when you finally reach Shakem, and the monsters are quite strong, so you can just level it up a few times and move on. Another great place if you don't want to go to Elnaut are the Blue Dragon Turtles and Leafrim. And of course, you can go to Selkie and Junior Slimy, but those maps are usually way too crowded. So next up, oh my god, I'm going so fast, is the Time Lane. This place is my absolute favorite. The background music is amazing. I like the monsters. I like the path. I like the accomplishment that I feel when I finally reach Pink Bean. You have to fight your way through the Temple of Time, and this will take a lot of time and also a lot of quests to do. But in the end, it's so rewarding. And I finally smack the smirk out of Pink Bean's face. Wonderful. So from level 165 to 250, we go to Official Knights and Sickness Knights. You can find these in the Gate of Future. And this is still a quite decent training spot, not what it used to be, but it's fine, I guess. And after that, of course, we go to the Ancient Mixed Golems, the final station. Those monsters are so quite devastating and cause so many potions, but yeah, this is the best training spot there is. I hope you guys enjoyed, and thank you all for your criticism. If you have any more, if you know any other places, let us know in the comments. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.